Britney Spears is still yelling at the heavens that she sings live. At least she's not singing it. The pop diva talked to a Tel Aviv TV station about whether she sings live or not, and she went there again. Opening up that old can of worms, she says she does sing live in concert. You bastards. Adding, I'm dancing so much, I do have a little bit of playback, but there's a mixture of my voice and the playback. It really pisses me off because I'm busting my ass out there and singing at the same time, and no one ever really gives me credit for it. I watch a lot of crime TV shows, you know, spouses killing each other for revenge or for money. It's kind of a nice respite from US politics, which I'm very addicted to. I sometimes wonder when a spouse gets away with murder and they decide to live in the small town still, where everything happened. I'm sure the first few years when they're buying their broccoli at the department store, there's someone behind them yelling, "You're murdered!" But it probably dies down after a couple of years. You can buy your Preparation H in private. Sure, they're still thinking you're a murderer, but at least they're not yelling it in your face. We are way past the point of whether Britney Spears lip syncs or not. And many fans come to her show in spite of that. There are a lot of people who are homers, we call. People who will go to your show. They're fans. They're true fans. You could be killing kittens on stage, and they'd still yell, "Yeah, right on! Get more kittens up there!" We've seen a lot of that in US politics lately. Those homers don't care. They love the show. And the other half of the people, whatever the quota is, they know she puts on a great show. Hell, I'd probably like her show if I went. No, I wouldn't. But anyway, it's a spectacle. It's a great show. But here's the thing. Thou dost protest too much. There are certain things we just know. And just because you say something doesn't make it true. Again, we live in the society now that an artist will say things and a majority sometimes of the fans will believe them. I've done a lot of interviews. I've been to radio 32 years, and it's very rare for a manager, a handler, a tour promoter to come up to you and say, "Hey, don't ask about the thing. Don't ask Richard about the gerbil." It's rare for that to happen, but it has happened before. Just before interviewing Joyce DeWitt of Three's Company's fame, I was asked not to mention John Ritter because he had just died like 2-3 weeks before. But I had to ask, and I understand this person at this Tel Aviv TV station had to ask, but Britney, come on, we know. You're like the widow in that small town coming up with a placard just because you're not getting the attention anymore saying, "You do know I'm the one that got away with murder, right? It was me." Some people, when they become celebrities, emotionally, they just stop growing. I'm not saying necessarily Britney's like that, but I will say she's been a celebrity for a heck of a long time, since she's been about this high. I remember once someone asking her, "What's the creepiest thing about being a celebrity?" She says, "Well, you know, men looking at me that way." I'm going, "You're wearing that clothing, man." But she was young, and at the time I understood it. And of course there's uproars over the net because she stirred this hornet's nest all over again. How could she avoid it? I don't know. Have someone say, "Don't ask that question," even though it's the pink elephant in the room. Let it go. Keep buying your broccoli and Preparation H in the department store. Hope that no one really notices that what's happening on stage is not really happening on stage. But what? If people are happy, who cares? Make sure you comment on her videos. Oh boy. Subscribe to her channel. And, you know, we don't usually cover people like Britney Spears. Artists of that ilk, we don't. We're mostly classic rock. A lot of performers who sing live on stage. But subscribe to our channel, like I mentioned, and comment on our website and our Twitter and Facebook stuff. It's down below. It's on the bottom. I'm John Bowden from Rock History Music.